Our technology is so fast, dental laboratory technology and also printing technology. This video is I would like to share with you guys how I'm using digital denture for implants. Stay tuned. So why I'm using the digital denture? So a couple of reasons I would like to share. Number one, we have our implant cases, 4 or 5 implant cases, and then we made the bite block and the verification jig. I all the time explain to you, which is stage one. And then after they set up, bite block, and then they make the wax try in, which is we did a really nice job, aesthetic, contour, everything. But is the problem is here. Whenever I deliver it to doctors, and doctor try in the patient's mouth and the tooth is falling apart. Sometimes they get the occlusion, it's hard to get the occlusion contact because wax try in is holding the wax, which is temporary, it's not rigid. So we cannot get a great, perfect study cases, but pros, we can easily changing. Whenever doctor said, can you move to this? Can you make the longer easily changing? But anyway, regardless, so nowadays our laboratory is changing everything. I would like to make the printing denture. Why? I don't have to do milling, which is to me not good idea because I do have a really good machine. I spend a lot of money and then 5 axis, great milling strategy. So we mill with the core PMMA. Right, here's the problem. Milling machine is, you have to spend $25,000 easily, but the printing machine $17,000. Milling time, 5 hours, all right? Time is money. But printing, 27 minutes. That's totally different. Number two, milling machine have to using the bar. Doesn't matter $25, $45, $65. The printing, I got the 1-piece or 2-piece. Easy way, huge benefit in order to saving the time, saving the money. Here's the cons. Whenever I make print denture, we deliver the doctor, very rigid. They can move anything, they can bite, they can even wear the temporary 3-6 months too. And the problem is when they say, look, his bite is really off, and midline is like this, or one side longer, then that's the problem. But once we get the photo and everything, we're reprinting again. That's the great part. So this video, a lot of people ask me, look, you know, digital denture is not pretty. I cannot sell to doctor, but there's a lot of a trick. This is education. A lot of people want to learn about how to apply the digital denture. So this is technique. We just printed EnvisionOne from EnvisionTEC, and then we just cured it from the pink, which is one color tone. But here is the one monotone, which is base color A1. So we're trying to make the is more translucency. We're trying to follow the old flipper denture. So here's what I do, usually what I trick between the tooth. I put subtle pink-orange color, just a little in between. And then A+, I add just a little bit subtle cervical area. Just add it, not that much, just a little, which is same. Okay, so increase the chroma. Between tooth, this if things too much, just remove it. But I'm a little bit subtle stain from the embrasure. Okay, you wanna see this more? Yep.
too much, just cut it. So basically I put the dentine apply from top of the fascia. So all the way up. And then canine is a little bit darker, so you can make it a little bit darker cervical area, like this. Right? And then I'm using the blue just a little bit in between major and distal corner, increase the translucency. And then the other side too, just subtle, don't get too much. Okay. Then irregular color should be okay. Now let's move on to lateral. This here, you don't have to go that much. Okay. So blue, you can, or you can use light gray. Here's okay, that is too much. Just a little bit, cut it. Just subtle, all right? You don't have to make it even. See, it's some translucency. Okay, I wanna put the little cervical area a little bit darker with the orange, light orange pink. See, maximize it, the chroma. This, right? It's good. L2. And then increase the little translucency. Like that. And L2. Here is the K9. Alright, basically 6 unit. We're almost done. And they're using the white horizontal line a little bit in between the tooth. Like this. See, too much. They're halo. Like this. Then halo too. A little bit horizontal line. A simple technique to matching the dental teeth. Make the better. You wanted the mamelon, I could put a little mamelon here. And then also another tip, you wanna go to the gingiva, has a little bit more wider. So you can make a little bit wider effect here. Okay. So we maximize it. Digital denture, digital implant actually. And then you could put the subtle stain in between. Maximize it. It looks like the tooth. Pink. Like this, right? You see the differences between the teeth. Just cure it. 10 minutes. You can get beautiful, better than this color. Right? So, here's the deals. Premolar is the same thing. Go to premolar, same thing, translucency with the A+, it's chroma. So basically we're trying to match A3, nice translucency with the dentine. Right, so embrasure too. So this is the 5-minute tips for you guys. The occlusion, same thing, you could make a little bit stain too. Like this. Yeah, you can do that as well. Now here's the same thing too. You just add cervical area like that. This is the last, right? And then translucency with the gray or blue. Right? So you can get the final cosmetic implant denture. We make to create this beautiful restoration. I'm using the Optiglaze from GC America. Then you can order it. Then you can get great color. Thanks for watching. Thank you.